step down into darkness, open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Dear Holy Spirit, we praise you as the wisdom and life of our church. Fill us with your Spirit so that with Jesus we may live as the body of Christ. Help us to see that we should value the whole body of Christ and not just our part of the body. Help us care for all members of the body. We ask this through Jesus, who cares for all of us. Amen.
The opening hymn, Christ is our cornerstone, CPWI number 2, 729.
The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Blessed be the Lord, O God. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ. Blessed be the Spirit of God. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Divinity, Psalm 95. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of his hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hand prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalms 19, reading from verses 1 to 14. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. One day tells a tale to another, and one night imparts knowledge to another. Although they have no words or language, and their voices are not heard, their sound has gone out into all lands, and their message to the ends of the world. In the deep, as he set a pavilion for the sun, it comes forth like a bridegroom out of his chamber. It rejoices like a champion to run its course. It goes forth from the uttermost edge of the heavens and runs about to the end of it again. Nothing is hidden from its burning heat. The law of the Lord is perfect and revives the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure and gives wisdom to the innocent. The statutes of the Lord are just and rejoice the heart. The commandment of the Lord is clear and gives light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean and endures forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, more than much fine gold, sweeter far than honey in the comb. By then also is your servant enlightened, and in keeping them there is great reward. Who can tell how often he offends? Cleanse me from my secret faults. Above all, keep your servant from presumptuous sins. Let them not get dominion over me. Then shall I be whole and sound, and innocent of great offense. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Exodus chapter 20, reading from verses 1 to 17. And God spoke all these words: I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven above or on earth beneath, or in the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you nor your son or daughter, nor your male or female servant, nor your animals, nor any foreign residing in your towns. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them. But he rested on the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. Honor your father and your mother, so that they may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his male or female servant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. The word of the Lord.
From the Word of God, written in St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 1, verses 18 through to 25. For the message about Christ's death on the cross is nonsense to those who are being lost, but for us who are being saved, it is God's power. The scripture says, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and set aside the understanding of the scholars. So then, where does that leave the wise, or the scholars, or the skillful debaters of this world? God has shown that this world's wisdom is foolishness. For God in his wisdom made it impossible for people to know him by means of their own wisdom. Instead, by means of the so-called foolish message we preach, God decided to save those who believe. Jews want miracles for proof, and Greeks look for wisdom. As for us, we claim the crucified Christ, a message that is offensive to the Jews and nonsense to the Gentiles. But for those whom God has called, both Jews and Gentiles, this message is Christ, who is the power of God and the wisdom of God. For what seems to be God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and what seems to be God's weakness is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord.
The hymn for the gradual. By the rivers of Babylon, CPWI number 544.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John chapter 2, beginning at verse 13. When it was almost time for the Jewish Passover, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple courts he found men selling cattle, sheep and doves, and others sitting at tables exchanging money. So he made a whip out of cords and drove all from the temple area, both sheep and cattle. He scattered the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold doves he said, "Get these out of here. How dare you turn my father's house into a market?" His disciples remembered that it is written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." Then the Jews demanded of him, "What miraculous sign can you show us to prove your authority to do all this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple and I will raise it again in 3 days." The Jews replied, "It has taken 46 years to build this temple, and you are going to raise it in 3 days?" But the temple he had spoken of was his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples recalled what he had said. Then they believed the scripture and the words that Jesus had spoken. Now while he was in Jerusalem at the Passover feast, many people saw the miraculous signs he was doing and believed in his name. The Gospel of Christ.
Anointed, fall on me. Set me free. Let the power of your Holy Ghost fall on me. Anointing, fall on me. Anointing, fall on me. Anointing, set me free, and let the power of your Holy Ghost fall on me. Anointing, fall on me.
Let us pray. Lord, you have been our dwelling place through all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth or ever, thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, "Return, ye children of men." Almighty God, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. We thank you, Lord, that even though at times we are self-indulgent, seeking our own desires, Lord, and not focusing and giving you your glory and honor, you never fail to love us and to continue to shower down your blessings. Thank you, Lord, that when we made our promises to you, when we break our promises, your promises that you made to us, they stand true. So Lord, I'm asking you to just continue to bless us, Lord, and bless the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our heart, now and always, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Looking at the lessons for this week, one word came to mind. indulgence. According to the Merriam Dictionary, indulgence is the act of giving way to one's desire. And when we look at the first lesson, Exodus chapter 20, God gave some words, and at the top of the words that the Lord gave to Moses, the set of rules for us to live by as children of God, it stated, I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. He continued to tell them, you shall not make for yourself any idol, whether in form of anything that is in heaven above, or that is on the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them, nor worship them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing children for the iniquity of parents to the third and fourth generation of those who reject me, but showing steadfast love to the thousandth generation of those who love me and keep my commandments. Today, the psalmist, the writer of Psalm 19, begun telling us how the heavens declares God's glory, and how the firmament of this earth shows God's handiwork. It says one day tells its tale to another, and one night imparts knowledge to another, although they have not words or language, and their voices are not heard. Their sound is still going out into all the lands, and their message to the ends of the world. If all of God's creation can show and glorify God, what about us, God's greatest creation, mankind? When God made us, he made us with the ability to reason, to think. He made us with the capability to discern, to gain wisdom. We are the only one of God's creation that he made with everything. Yet we are the one who praise him the least, who acknowledges God the least. We are so focused on ourselves that we forget that God is who we are supposed to worship. Today's John Gospel points to the festivity of the Passover that was near. And at the Passover, Jews go up to Jerusalem to celebrate. And as they were there, we know that they normally offer different types of animals for different types of sins. So these were the offering. And they were already in the temple. Those in the courtyard presenting the place ready for those who wanted to purchase, who wanted to change money. They were busy about so many other things. But there was nothing about the worship, the true worship. Where was the heart in this worship? Where was the thanks for God delivering them out of Egypt, bringing them to a land that was promised, providing for them, fighting off the enemies that were on the left and on the right? Where were the thanks? The thanks was in the material, but it wasn't in the heart. Upon seeing this, Jesus got angry. And you call this a righteous anger. When Jesus started throwing out everything, the gospel said that Jesus made a whip and he started drove out everybody, turning over the tables, telling them who were selling doves to take them things and get out of the house of God and not to make his father's house a marketplace. We can look at this gospel today and say, not me, not me. But when we come to God, what is it that we place first? Are we particular about how we dress, what we wear? And when you come, where you sit? Are we particular about who is going to take communion, who is not? Of our hearts, the temple been prepared for God, for him to enter? Are we here to tell God, thank you for the week, the months, the years that has passed? Thank you for keeping us alive. Thank you for your provision over the years. Thank you, Lord, for the near misses. Thank you for the illnesses that we have overcome. Thank you that regardless of the situations, we're still paying our bills. We are still alive. Are we telling God thanks? Are we truly glorifying God? Giving him his honor and glory? Or do we look at others and hope that others will do it for us? It's funny when you look in the gospel appointed for this morning. Why is it you have 6 days to labor and the seventh day? The Passover is kept on a certain day. Why is it then that those who were offering offerings couldn't get what they want before the day of the celebration? It tells about the interests that we put in God. If I'm going to buy a house, I have to plan for it, save for it, do everything that is needed to purchase the house. So why we don't put all of that preparation in the things we do for God? Why is it that every time we do something, we do it half-heartedly? Less thought, less time. But the things of the world, we find time and we put everything into it. What time and effort do we put aside to God? How are we indulging this Lenten season in the things of God? Are we saying it is too hard? We never have the money to get the things yet, so we can't pay the offering.
the bills extra this month, so boy, God, I forgot to wait till next month. What is it that is keeping us from truly honoring God? Remembering that God doesn't want an offering that is not from the heart. That's useless to Him. When we give to God, we must give Him with everything in us. If it's just from the top of our lips, why sing? Why pray? Why praise? But we find, even as children of God, it is so difficult to really focus on God and the things that are of God. Even when He takes us down into a dungeon, it is hard to let go and let God. But today's lessons, all of them, Paul's letter to the Corinthians is letting us know that without God, everything that we do and say is foolish. We feel we have the gift to discern, but our discernment is skewed. We feel that we are wise, but our wisdom is foolishness if God is not in it. Normally, we would be in a church. We would be celebrating the different rituals of worship. But once more, we are in our own homes, closed in. Can we worship the Lord from where we are? Or are we worrying about the communion that we're not getting? The service, the singing, and all of those, the people that we're not seeing. When we look today and what is happening, reflecting back on last year when COVID-19 just came in, what was our desire then? What is our desire now? Can we still see God clearly? Can we still worship God from where we are? The children of Israel, when they found themselves once more enslaved, one of their songs, one of their questions was, how can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? Well, you're not in your church, your place of worship. Can you sing the Lord's song? Can you truly worship God? Because anywhere we are, God is, as long as we seek to truly worship. Can we bend the knee of our heart, like in the prayer of Manasseh, and ask the Lord to forgive us? Can we seek out the things that we indulge in that are not of God and try to find the things to indulge in that are of God? Can we truly honor and worship God as God? Psalm 90 tells us that only God is God. Thou art God before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Thou art God. Thou art God. Revelation tells us He's Alpha
and Omega, the beginning and the end. Psalm 86 verse 10 says, you are great, you the wondrous things, you are God alone. Is this how we see God? When the heavens can declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork, is it how we show God? What are the doves and the different things that we indulge in, that we are more focused on and not focused on God? What are they? This Lent, can we put them away? Can we put away all these idols? And can we place God front and center of our lives? Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Can we truly do that? Are we so caught up in ourselves and our world that we forget that we are not of this world? We are just in it. We're not of it. Our world is with God. Our world is God. Our world is wherever God is and the things of God. Are we seeking out the fruits of the Spirit? Are we loving God above all things and then loving our neighbors as ourselves? Are we forgiving? Are we caring for others? Or are we so focused on ourselves that we forget that the world is not just us? Let us put away selfish indulgence and let us turn back to God. Let us desire God above all things and desire what it is that he has asked us to do. Take up the cross. Take up the cross and follow him. He knows the cross is heavy, but as long as we take up our cross, as long as we turn our eyes on him, as long as we look to him, he's able to make that cross a light burden for us. Will we turn to him today? Let us indulge a little in some things that are upright and pleasing to God, especially loving God with all our hearts, with all our mind, with all our soul. Let us love one another. And yes, let us forgive and smile. Whatever it is, God is able. Whatever it is, God will take us through. If we just turn our focus on him. So today, put away the offering that is not from the heart. And let us give him the offering that is true, that he seeks, and that will continue to help us to have a deeper relationship
with our Lord. It isn't easy, nor was it easy for him. But if he can give his life for us, why can't we give ours to him? Amen.
Understand why we're at a place in our lives where we're tired of all the lies and the pain we feel inside. We want to make it right. I have nothing else to give except my life. Please accept this offering. I present my body, my sacrifice. Holy. Grace and the sacrifice you've made, I gotta make it right. I have nothing else to give except my life. Oh, please accept my offering. I present my body, my sacrifice. You love. end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. Everybody say it, say it.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me.
You ought to close your eyes and sing that till you believe it.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me.
Singing it till you believe it. Say, at the end of the day. Let's go. Sing at the end of the day.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day.
Put your hands in the air.
Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Suffrage, eh? Lord, reveal your love among us. Grant peace within and among all nations. Endow your church with faithfulness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed. Lord, renew your spirit within us. Almighty God, you know that we have no power in ourselves to help ourselves. Keep us both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you make us glad in the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. On behalf of our Rector Father Jones and Mrs. Jones, we welcome all of you who have joined us online for our care service this morning. As we adjust to the new challenges which the COVID-19 pandemic has created for our church, we are thankful, however, that we are able to meet in this virtual space to worship God and to proclaim His word. Our notices are as follows. Even as we grapple with COVID, please remember the sick and shut-in and elderly members and friends of our church family, many of whom are alone. Let's keep them in our prayers this week, and if possible, give them a call or run an errand for them. We ask special prayers for Father Jones and Mrs. Sybil Eiton, who is currently a patient at the University Hospital. We pray for God's guidance of the medical team which is treating her condition and for a speedy recovery. The 6 weeks Lenten Bible study led by young people in the province of the West Indies continues this evening at 7 o'clock via Zoom. Last week, our sister Shanae Morgan Thomas from St. Martin's Mission did an excellent presentation on creation and the Creator's intent. Both the youths and adults who participated learned so much, and I am sure you are all looking forward this evening to this evening's session. Please check our CARE WhatsApp pages for the Zoom link. You are also reminded to read about baptism and its relevance in all areas of our lives in the Lenten Bible Study Guide, which has been produced for churches in the province of the West Indies. The guide is posted on the Diocesan website as well as in our CARE WhatsApp group. A meeting of the St. Boniface Mothers Union is scheduled for tomorrow evening at 6 o'clock. Details regarding this meeting will be posted on WhatsApp. You are invited to support Celebrate Jesus, the annual sacred concert hosted by St. Luke's Church Crossroad. The show will feature a host of top-line performers. Will begin at 5 p.m. This afternoon on the Flow and Digicel cable networks. Access is free, but donations are welcome for the church, senior citizens, residents. The annual St. Boniface Easterburn project is now underway. Please send in your orders early, as final deliveries will be made on March 29. The price list and arrangement for placing orders will be posted on our CARE pages. We look forward to your usual support for this project, the proceeds from which help to finance St. Boniface outreach programs. Finally, please tune in as usual at 4:45 this afternoon for Think on These Things on Radio Jamaica 94 FM, and at 6 o'clock on Love 101 Radio for a rebroadcast of this morning's service at the St. Andrew Parish Church, where Archbishop Gregory was celebrant and preacher. Okay, there goes Lizard. Our birthdays for the week. Special thanks to everyone who contributed to and participated in our live service this morning. We hope you were blessed by this act of worship. Please have a God-guided week. Let's do our part to help curb the spread of COVID-19 by observing the health protocols and disaster risk management regulation, and stay safe. The recessional hymn number CPWI 116, Jesu, who this all Lenten tide. Mm-hmm. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord.